Okay, in this video, we're going to go over some 3D printing today. Plasticity, at its core, is a CAD software, so it's perfect for any 3D printing projects. So I put up, I put this little package together here for you to use. These are 3D printing guides for most of the common 3D printers out there. I specifically like using FDM myself. Resin is always just so messy, and I don't ever really play with it, so FDM is basically what I like to play with. But I've got several templates here that you can use for your projects, and they are all sized accordingly, all the way from 180 cubed to 210, 220, 225, 256, all the way up to the big guys, 360 and 420. And their particular sizes there for the big FDM machines. And you can also use this with, you can actually make your own with this, and I'll show you how here shortly. But let me show you how I like to use this here. So let me pull up my 3D printing guides here. I'm going to grab 220 by 220 by 250. That's the size of my current printer. Kind of a smaller guy. So I'm going to copy him, and I have a new window pulled up here. And if I just do Control V, there we go. Now he's all by himself there. Okay. So now I could take any of my old projects that I didn't really have any size reference in mind, and I can use it to get my size perfect for my 3D printer. So let's go ahead and grab another file here. So as you can see, I got this gun all fused together, Boolean together, ready for 3D printing with a couple extra parts here. But the size isn't right. So it's like 378 or 378 millimeters currently, because I didn't really have any thoughts in mind what size I was playing with when I built this model. I was just playing with the program. So what I'm going to do is going to do A, Control C. I'm going to take it in that new file that I created here. Okay. And I can do Control V. Give it a second to send it over. There it is. And I'm going to just throw him in his own group there. So now I can scale this guy to the correct size. At least for my particular use case here. So I want him be about the size of the print bed. I'm actually going to cut him up eventually. I'll show you how to do that, but for the sake of this video, we're not going to do that. So he's about the right size now. So now all I have to do is just come up here, export. Obviously, we would do a little more work here. Let's do, put it in the right folder here. And just do gun print. And I should have saved them as a STL, not a STP. But you, most slicers can accept STPs. So we'll go over that in another video there. And it's still, I swear, that's interesting. There it goes. Brought up the dialogue now. And I'm just going to max him out. 1.0. Going to be very dense, which is fine. Okay. Now let's pull up Prusa. And let's find our print. There he is. There we go. Brought him over just fine. No errors, nothing. So we can print them just like this if we wanted, slice it, but I would highly recommend cutting up your model to make it work better, and I'll show you that in another video. This was just a kind of showcase. Yeah, it definitely wants me to cut it up there because the supports are going outside the outside the print area, which is fine. But I just wanted to show you how easy it was to just resize models using these 3D print guides. Let's go back to the main one here. And a couple other things that it does come with is this little test cube. It's a 50 millimeter test cube there that you can print off. Also have some first layer adhesion if you need to work on your first layer there. A couple different versions there, 180, a 150, a 250, and a 320. That will help you determine if your very first layer is adhering correctly or if it's too close. So a lot of you familiar with FDMs will like these little guides down here to play with. Everything here will be on my Gumroad and QBrush there for free. I'll also have an STL version for anybody else that wants to use it in other CAD softwares like Fusion 360, SolidWorks, and what have you. So, but that's it for today. 3D print guides. Just kind of help you out on your 3D printing adventures. We'll catch you in the next video.